This trend line has never been broken. There is a very bearish scenario that price is possibly going in a direction. Hey everyone, thank you so much for joining in today's episode. So since my last video, I actually gained 50 new subscribers with this single video, and it's also one of my most watched video. Guys, thank you for making this possible, and also welcome to all new subscribers. So since our last video, Bitcoin has actually shown a really nice positive growth, and also it has pierced our first target area, which was 7,000, and also almost reached our second target area, that was 7,500. But here is a twist, guys, and that's why I thought, why not to make a video right away, since we can see that the price of Bitcoin is getting pulled back in some sort of way, right? But there is a twist, and the twist is, if you look at this price action from Bitcoin from the early stage of February in 2020, this trend line, the yellow trend line which I've drawn, has never been broken. So if you look at this one, right, when the price was actually trying to break this trend line, it got retraced back, and again this trend line acted as a resistance. Same here back in February, right, 24th of February, price well down, and when it came back around, tested the area, it again acted as a resistance and the price fell back again. And now, since we are at the same area, it is very, very important for Bitcoin to hold this position, because if Bitcoin is actually going to retrace back, then I'm very, very worried that we are going to break this trend line. And that's not a good sign, because since Bitcoin is here right now around like 7,400, 7,500 area, this is a very critical area. So Bitcoin must stay above this area, as I've said plenty of time in my previous video, that only then we have a possibility of going in upper direction. But if the price actually retraced back below the 7,000 area, then it's a very bearish scenario for Bitcoin, guys. And also looking at this, the distribution schematic from wickups, range and phases, this is also going to pan out then one-to-one, because right now you can see I've drawn a trend line from between, and this trend line is going to be where I think the price of Bitcoin might retrace back in the coming days, because we have never seen like price going in a continue in upper direction. There is some kind of retracement as well. So what I'm actually hoping is maybe we will see some kind of like double top appearing and then price coming in a downward direction, right? So this trend line is going to be one of the really important area for Bitcoin, because one thing which is already pushing us below is that this trend line is not letting Bitcoin to pass over it. So if Bitcoin actually wants to continue in upper direction, it has to break this trend line. So if Bitcoin actually pass over this area, then guys, this 7,500 is just going to be a normal target area, because after that I'm hoping directly that the price of Bitcoin might jump around 8,000 area. And why 8,000 area? It's not just I said from thin air, guys. That's my target area, and how I actually calculated it, I'll show you a pretty simple way, right? So if this is my swing high from my rising wedge, right, and this is swing low, you just need to find the area from where the trend actually start breaking. For example, here is our, in our case, this is the scenario, right, till the swing high of your wedge. So you just need this area, just place it from where the trend actually broke, right? So in this way you will find the area of, like, I would say a target area where the price of Bitcoin might possibly go. So this is where I'm expecting Bitcoin to go if this trend line is broken, right? So for Bitcoin, it's very, very critical right now to hold around between 7,000 or 7,500. So it's not allowed to break below the 7,500. Because if it actually breaks below the 7,500, our scenario is going to be just like this, guys. This is a very, very bearish scenario, because you can see here, right? When the UT, the upper trust line, is broken, there is a very bearish scenario that price is possibly going in a direction from where it came from, right? So, and if Bitcoin actually breaks this trend line, let's suppose we are going to 8,000 area. Also very interesting is that this logarithmic, Bitcoin logarithmic growth curve, will be intact. So I mean, if the price is around 8,000, then we are back again, guys, following this logarithmic growth curve. And this is also very, very interesting at this moment, that for Bitcoin most critical is this one. We can see this line has acted as a resistance plenty of time from the past history. So this time, if Bitcoin want to pass, it has to cross over this area, right? Cross over this line. So only then we will enter this 8,000 phase. But if this line gets broken, we are looking to go around 8,000 area. And also if we reach to 8,000 area, this Bitcoin logarithmic growth curve will be continued as it has been since the early days. So guys, right now, Bitcoin is in a very, very interesting situation. As we can see, right, we are expecting some kind of price pullback, but we hope that price pullback is not going to be below $7,000. If the price actually comes below the $7,000, then this is going to be a very, very bearish scenario, just like in this example. Okay, and but if it actually stays above this area or between this area, 7,000 and 7,500, then it's still in a green area, so that price might still continue in upper direction, but only if this trend line gets broken. But if this trend line gets broken, then I think 8,000 also wouldn't be a bigger deal for Bitcoin. Then we will continue this Bitcoin logarithmic growth curve. And guys, 90% of traders lose 90% of the initial investment within 90 days. So if you want to be within this 10%, you have to be very smart and also use proper risk management. So guys, by saying this, I want to end this video here. My name is Anoop, and yeah, happy hunting.